favor on this there, what they call these things? Roller coasters. These are really cool. A lot safer watching it on a video. I don't know if you've ever been in one, but it reminds me of being in the coal mine. I'm mining for gold and all these cryptocurrencies. That's how I get down to the bottom of the shaft. Say this looks a little more aggressive than I'm used to. Make me seasick. To Digitspin Crypto. I'm Miner 49er. Now, I'm taking over for today because it's a Thanksgiving Day special. And Dino's eating turkey. You'd think he'd invite me over or something, but he didn't. He just said, you take care of the show. So that's what I'm gonna do. Now, he told me to tell you. He said that this is not financial advice, so don't pretend it is. He said, I think that's about it. You want me to tell you that? That's basically what he wanted to say. All this other stuff, I don't understand all this fancy reading and writing stuff, but he said, it's not financial advice. He said he's a funny guy in a hat. Now, I'm not pointing my hat. Mine's quite stylish. You know, I skinned this myself. I had to wrestle me a 400-pound calf. Cow. It was a big good. It was a bull. It had horns. I had to wrestle me that thing. Tanned his hide and turned it in myself into a hat. So my hat's got style and looks good on me. That's for sure. So, what we want to talk today is about cryptocurrency. This is all good stuff. I hope you got some. Because collecting cryptocurrency is going to be the future. Obviously, you're watching this video, so you already know that. Yeah, it's pretty simple, right? Collect cryptocurrency, then you'll be prepared. Prepare for the future. There's a turkey. That's a big old turkey. I hope you got yourself a turkey. Now, when I was looking for turkeys, they were a lot more muscular. Weren't so fat and juicy as like this guy here. This guy, he's really juicy. He'd make good eating. on that campfire. That's for sure. Gotta like it. Like fresh food. Alright. So, let's take a look. See what's going on today for this Thanksgiving weekend. I know you're getting fluffy stuffed up, getting yourself turkey, getting yourself stuffing, maybe some cranberry sauce. I had me meatloaf. It was good meatloaf. With some gravy, some peas, and I found some wild berries. So that was some tasty stuff. So I hope you're relaxed, enjoying yourself. I saw myself a parade. They had all these giant balloons. That was fun. That was fun to watch on that there TV. That was good stuff. Yeah, those were good. All right. So, what I wanted to see is let's take a look at what's going on in the cryptos. And they have this thing here. It's called a coin market cap. This here website tells you all sorts of good stuff. It has prices and quantities, and even has a little graph tell you what's going on, so you can just look at it real quickly like. And I was noticing this there Bitcoin scared the daylights out of me. Let's bring this up real quick. It started off, and the price started to go down. Now luckily, it changed its mind. And now we're back up to $7,700. You imagine that? You collecting these cryptos 8 years ago, digging them up, putting them in your pocket by spoonfuls, and today they're just worth so much. Those fellas, they had what you call the ability to hang tight. They knew that over time, the cryptocurrency becomes worth more. So, if you're digging up crypto, or you're buying crypto from your local general store, you make sure you hold on to it for a while. Don't be whining and complaining all the time that it ain't going up today. Because it takes time. Takes time for crypto to get more valuable. And these fellas knew that. They have thousands of these there crypto bitcoins. And look at it now. $7,700. Now, I saw a chart. Let's look at that real quickly like. See this here? See all this here volume? See all this here? People start to manipulate the price. They drop it down. You know why they drop it down? They want you to panic. They want you to run around and lose the rope of your horse. Forget where you put the wheel for your carriage. Drop a horseshoe. They don't care. They want you to scream and run and see the price drop, and sell your crypto to them cheap, so that they can put it in the bank, and when the price goes up, they'll sell it to the next guy at 2 times the price. But, see, you're watching mine, a 49er. I know these tricks. I've been watching this for hundreds of years. Or at least 100 years, 150 years. 170 years. 170 years. I see this stuff happen all the time. And they just try to scare you, get you to get rid of your Bitcoin, and then they just scoop it up on you. And when the price goes up, you're sitting there scratching your hat going, why'd I give away my Bitcoin? Because you're goofy. That's why you gave it away, because you're goofy. That only way I could say that, you're goofy. And then you look, and the price built right back up. Now, when this price went down here, you see this. I went to my local general store. I bought me some of them their bitcoins at what they call an ATM. That's right, a Bitcoin ATM. And I put the money in. It's only a little piece of paper. Imagine that. They give me bitcoins. All I have to do is put like $100 and make the paper green. And then I take that $100. Oh, can you see my $100? And I stick it in this there machine and they give me Bitcoin for the piece of paper. Isn't that funny? They give me real Bitcoins for these little fake pieces of paper. So, I throw that in there and I get me some Bitcoin. And that's what I did. I got me Bitcoin and it was at $7,000. And now, the price went back up. It's been jumping up. And then they tried to do it again. They tried to scare you. And then the price go back up. And then they try to scare you. Then the price go back up. It's like watching a Scooby-Doo movie.
I don't know, Shaggy.
It's funny stuff. Let's see, who do we got out there today? Let's look at what they call the chat. So I see a couple folks. Couple fellas out there. I see Christopher. I see Carl Ultra. And I see Borg. Is that Borg? Borgé? Borg? Borg Anderson. I don't know how to say that stuff. I had meeting so many Swedish people. Mostly Europeans, but you know, out here mining for gold, but you know, don't know all the Swedish words. And then I see more Carl. I see Michael out there. Good to see you, Michael. We got a road bump. And road bump says, hey. Hey, my 49er. He goes, you've been hitting the bottle again? Well, I love me whiskey. That's for sure. Gotta have some whiskey. I take my whiskey. And I poured in my Electroneum mug. And then I just goofed that. Dip, 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 dip. It's some good stuff. Electroneum. With some whiskey in it. I love me saloon girls too. That's good stuff. Now, Dino also gave me these instructions here. He said I'm supposed to answer questions. So, he said if you had questions to tell you, to put them on the chat. Was it this way, that way? I don't know. Put them on the chat. And he said, be honest and tell them what you think. So, first thing I was doing was telling you, I was thinking, I bought some good Bitcoin. So I'm hoping to see some more Bitcoin, but I had to get a little bit of Electroneum too. Ooh, it's good stuff, Electroneum. I stole away my Electroneum, buried it in a little container. I dig up a hole and I stick it in the hole, bury it back up so I can have it later on. It's a good way to store my crypto. Let's see. So this here fella, Chris, he said Dino not only adds value, but he makes us smile. So since Dino ain't here, you're talking about mine 49er. Mine 49er, yeah, I'm working hard to try to do a good job today on the Turkey Day special. Carl Ultra. Carl says, what do you think of VNX technology, Dino? I don't know. Dino's not here. Yeah, I don't know what VNX is. Very nasty excedrin. I don't know what that is. Let's see if we can look it up. I have other things to talk about here, too. But let's see. VNX. I don't know if this is a coin. If this is what is VNX storage? software environments, mid-range enterprise products, unifies file-based, block-based offerings into a single product. I don't know. I haven't read anything about this. I don't know. I guess I'd have to look it up before I could mumble in my mouth. Let's see what else is going on. Now, I was also looking at that there Electroneum. Electroneum's been doing good too. I noticed this week, all my Electroneum worth a whole lot more. It went from a third of a penny to a fourth of a penny. That's not bad. Not bad. But I know that Electroneum is going to be worth many, many pennies. I'm going to keep holding on to it. And the reason is, there's a lot of good stuff. I look at this Twitter here. In this Twitter, they hired this fair fellow, David Bull. Now, you guys all know this already because you've been watching all the shows and watching Digitspin Crypto. I'm sure he's told you about it. But he's gonna put Electroneum's name in front of a lot of other NGOs, non-governmental operations. We didn't have those back then, but today they seem to be a helpful type of business. And this fella, he was the CEO of the UK for the UNICEF. That's for the UN. So, you know this man knows a lot of people. He's able to connect with people, let them know about the great stuff Electroneum can do. I'm holding on to my Electroneum. What's in your wallet, huh? You better hold on to some too. Carl said, that's what the Rothschilds did, Dino. That's right. They got a hold of their money, they held on to it, and now the whole family getting more money than you can shake a stick at. And I can shake a stick real good. But they got lots of money. A lot of those fellas, they ended up building new industries. It wasn't only the gold, but they ended up building the railroads, they ended up making oil. And all those guys, all those fellas, they turned into tycoons. So my 49er knows from experience that you want to be involved in this crypto, because it's not just the crypto. It'll be everything around it that will make other people tycoons. Now, mine a 49er, I'm just a guy. I like to dig and mine. So I mine a lot of my coins. Stuff them in a bag, put a knot around it, put it on my horse. Christopher says he ain't ever selling. That's a smart fella. You and me need to meet up at the saloon. Watch a couple saloon girls dancing with the piano man and get some of that dirty world, Diddy Bird, dirty beer water. So we can get some whiskey too. Like whiskey. Christopher says he ain't scared. He ain't scared. Well, if you can make it to the saloon without getting shot, then you're doing good. Christopher says, too, that sweeties eat a lot of fish. Why do they eat a lot of fish? Because they got water all over? You would think, I would think that they'd eat chocolate and fish. Maybe that's why they had Swedish fish. And a little candy Swedish fish. Road bump. We got a road bump. Road bump saying, hey there, mine a 49er. Do you have any of that web dollars? We need another giveaway. I'll talk to that fella, Dino. Tell him that you need some more giveaways for a web dollar. From what I understand, he has a big bag of web dollars sitting around here waiting to be given away. So, I'll tell him to get his act together, stop goofing off, because he goofs off all the time. He's always goofing off. I'm working all the time, he's goofing off. So I'll tell that fella to get some WebD going. Marge says he wish he could mine beer. Well, you can mine them little nuggets and turn them into beer. But you can hold on to them too. Sounds like you got yourself a problem there, don't you? Because beer is important. We got Art 2000. Now this here fella, Art 2000, he's right, where is he? Right there. He has himself a YouTube channel. And he was whining and complaining about Electroneum, but now I think he likes Electroneum again. Because they're doing good stuff. Good stuff. So it's good to see Art 2000. He's a good guy named Chuck. When you got a name like Chuck, you got to be a good guy. Absolutely. We got Crypto Man. Crypto Man says, sell that energy and buy more ETN. Yeah, you know, there's so many coins out there. I think a lot of them ain't gonna be worth much. If it's just a coin, doesn't do anything, just a store of value, you probably end up using Bitcoin. Now, I dig up and I get myself Bitcoins. I look at this list. There's a big list here. I like that they're Bitcoin. Because that's the best store of value. I like that they're Ethereum. Ethereum's good stuff. And I think that they're going to make a lot of financial applications to make it work a lot better than it does today. You'd be able to borrow, you'd be able to loan, never have to sell your cryptocurrency. You'll be able to put it into the Ethereum wrapper finance systems. And then they just send you more crypto. And then you do is you cash that crypto out, or you use that to buy something. This way you don't have to sell. XRP. I am a little bit of XRP. Not one of my favorites. This here tether. That's basically the same as this little piece of paper. You can stick these in that ATM and get free crypto. Bitcoin Cash. Bitcoin SV. These just rich fellas who had a whole bunch of Bitcoin. Made another coin, gave themselves a whole bunch more Bitcoin. I never ever gonna buy a coin that was modeled off of Bitcoin. It should start from zero. Shouldn't be an instant windfall for those that already have the Bitcoin. Why should I give them more money? Now, if they took it and built it again and started it from the beginning, where you could mine from the beginning, that's a fair coin. But if you're gonna clone a coin and fork it and give yourself a whole bunch more coins out of no reason whatsoever, you're ripping people off. That's a scam in my eyes. I never would put money into those. These people already have buckets of them. And that's not a fair delivery system. Just making those Bitcoin guys more Bitcoins. It's silly. Absolutely silly. Don't buy any coins that make others free money. They should have to earn it like everybody else and mine it themselves. start from the beginning. That's all goofy to me. Seems rather stupid. Litecoin. I don't think I'd buy Litecoin. When I get Bitcoin. Give me some Bitcoin. Bitcoin, Bitcoin, Bitcoin. Gotta have Bitcoin. Now we get into these weirder coins. EOS, BNB, XLM, Tron, Cardano. Some of these gonna make some money. Don't know which ones, but they're all doing some pretty neat stuff. I think Cardano just went and made a shopping module to pay for stuff. Monero I like a lot. Problem is, all the exchanges are getting rid of it. It's all private, see? I can take the money, hide it under my beard. I take a Bitcoin, I put it here, and I can stick it in, and the Bitcoin's gone, and it's all gone, and then I can pull it out, and I got a Bitcoin. But government don't like it. They want to be able to look in your ears. They want to check what's under your hat. They want to look in your shirt. Just like the king. Goodman always want to look in your underwear, see what you got hiding in there. Let's see. I was looking at this news, and I saw on Bitcoin in China. It's way over there, in case you didn't know. It's pretty far. Real far. They're shutting down the exchanges. They say they're gonna do blockchain, but then they shut down exchanges or they close themselves. I don't know what's going on over there. They just keep making up stuff. They want to do, they don't want to do, they want to do, they don't want to do. What are you gonna do? We'll just go on without them. But then you got the US and China battling for blockchain dominance. So you know, once the Chinese say, hey, we're gonna do blockchain, you know, Americans gonna jump in and say, we're gonna do blockchain too. Well, everyone wanna do blockchain. Everyone wanna do blockchain, everyone wanna do Bitcoin, Bitcoin, everyone wanna Bitcoin. Absolutely. So United States gonna jump in there too. I don't see them. They always like to make laws. They're always putting laws on there. Making it tough. Make it tough to mine. Make it tough to hold on to. You can't even hold. Ooh, keep slipping out of my fingers. They just keep making it tougher and tougher. I don't know how they're going to make it easy for the American people to be able to mine and get Bitcoin. But they better do something quick. These Chinese smart fellas. And they know what they're doing. Know how to do this stuff. So, but guess we gotta pay attention. Yeah, gotta pay attention. Now, a lot of you like to spend your weekend spending your cryptocurrency, buying things on what they call Black Friday. I guess everybody goes and buys crazy stuff. Then on here, they talk about the stores that take your crypto. Now, if you want to get rid of it, that's fine with me. But there's this place here called Overstock. They sell lots of furniture and electronics and things. And they take Bitcoin, Ethereum, Dash, and Litecoin. So that's one place you can go. There's one called Redbubble. Now Redbubble, I've never been to a Redbubble. But it's supposed to do for artists and let's see, clothing and merchandise. So Redbubble takes your Bitcoin. And they have a lightning network. I don't know. Lightning networks. Sounds exciting. I know Dino knows about this stuff, but I don't know about this stuff. There's one called All Things Decentral. Now, they have hardware products, mining rigs, and hardware wallets. Make sure you get yourself one of them. I think they're even on sale. Get yourself a Ledger, an LPAL. I think there's some others you can get. Keep your crypto on a hardware wallet. Because if you keep it in a bag on your horse, and your horse disappears going down to the river, get some water, you lost your crypto. So you gotta hold on to it in a crypto wallet. There's a website called Fangamer. Now, Fangamer, they sell software from Capcom, Konami, and SNK. And then they have clothing collectibles too. All them gaming things that people play with and thing on TV. There's cryptos. There's a website called Kiosk. Let's see here, they sell magazines and artist books. 50% off everything and accepts crypto payments with its own BTC full note. So these fellas obviously know what they're doing. Now, this is one of my favorites called New Egg. Now, I go to New Egg, get myself some electronics. It's where I get my mining hardware. Get me them GPUs so I can set them up and mine all the different cryptocurrencies. So New Egg, they use BitPay. And they have digital wallets. So you can buy, you can earn those cryptos, make some, take that money, and buy yourself some more mining rigs. Rakuten. They have stuff here. Let's see. They have Groupons and JCPenney, Samsung. Looks like they take your crypto too. Reed's Jewelers. See, you can change your crypto, turn it into some gold. You can get discounts. So they take it. There's BitCars and BitDials. And of course, Cointelegraph online store takes over your crypto. So you get yourself some art. Maybe a shirt. Crypto. Cointelegraph. Let's see what we got out here. Christopher saying, says BTC will be massive. He believes Electroneum is going to also do things really well. They're going about things two different ways. You know, your Bitcoin, everybody has. The Electroneum, they're working within the framework of regulatory compliance. So that means you can take your Electroneum and these companies will be able to accept it knowing that it's fully KYC and AML, which is anti-money laundering. People always try to wash their money. They're out there scrubbing, adding more soap. Makes the paper. It's only paper. The paper gets all worn out. So you can't wash your money that much. Or you rub a hole in it. So government don't like when you wash your money. So they try to stop you. Let's see if there's any more questions. Chris is saying, says, keep on mining Electroneum, mourn your 49er. Soon it will become rare. Absolutely. Electroneum is really tough to get. Not that many around. And once everybody starts wanting to pick some up, price is going to go really high. You can see that over the weekend. And I was looking at that before. Soon as the volume starts going up and people start buying the Electroneum, the price just goes berserk. So you can see it in here. You get a little bit of volume, get a little bit of growth. get a lot of bit of volume, get a lot of bit of growth. Makes a lot of sense to me. Carl Ultra says, he says, what do you think of Monero being delisted? I think it's unfortunate that they're gonna take Monero and delist it from some of these exchanges. And some of these exchanges doing it all to themselves. Because they're just afraid. United States has big financial power. They got them big guns. And they start pop, 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 pop. And they start getting into your campfire. They kick around your fire, knock the ashes all over. So you don't put it on the exchange, nobody comes kick your campfire over. So that's what they're doing. And it's unfortunate. But there'll always be a need for Monero, just you'd have to go to the right exchanges to get it. And I think that you're gonna see more privacy being added in, even into Bitcoin. There's gotta be some privacy of information and details. Carl says, hey, mine 49er, have you ever been to the UK to mine, and have you traveled outside of the US? Well, traveling's kind of tough for me. All I got is my horse. He gets tired after about 20 miles. Now, he's not a youngster, but, you know, he's got some get up and go, and I can put lots of stuff in my satchel bags. He can carry me two big bags of cryptocurrency, one tied on each side. But he doesn't travel very far. So, I'm lucky to be able to make it to the next county. Never mind the other country. So no, never left. I just went to California, dug up some gold, dug up some cryptocurrencies, and stuck them in my bag, putting them on my horse. And I just kind of stayed right around there because it's way too hard. Christopher says, gotta use dynamite to mine those ETN. Now I use dynamite all the time. That makes the job a lot easier. You pull out a stick and you light the fuse, stick it in there, and boom, it opens up. It makes a whole big hole where you can collect all the cryptocurrency you want. But now it's a lot easier. I use the little GPU. I put the GPU in the computer and type on the keyboard. I got good keyboard typing skills. And that there goes out and it mines for me. Don't ask me how. I don't know. I don't know if it's a little robot or something digging away, but whatever. But it does the job. Carl says that you can buy a house with Electroneum in the UK. So that's good stuff. I knew you could. Eventually you'll be able to use Electroneum for everything. Be able to go down, use it at your local grocery. You'll be able to take your Electroneum phone and say, beep, beep. And it'll add up the amount and you can then pay for your car wash. Or horse wash in my case, and get yourself a new flannel shirt. Maybe I get my beard trimmed a little. I like my beard, but needs a trimming. I can pay for my beard getting trimmed. Definitely some whiskey. Definitely need whiskey. Gonna have to go to the saloon. Hey, we got a Jay Sullivan. Jay Sullivan, he sounds like a gambler to me. You play poker, Jay Sullivan? Come on down to the saloon. I play a game of poker. Bring you Electroneum. Let's see what else we got here on the questions. The BAFA. He says, when does Electroneum go to beta testing for any task? And I think they're doing some minor testing now with a small group of people, about 10. 10 people. And then once they get that all rattled out and get some feedback, then they'll bring it out to a bigger group. Maybe 12 people. No, they'll bring it out to a bigger group. So that'll probably take a couple weeks. And then they bring it out to more people. Risk Knower is out there. He says, I'd like an Intel 660p 2 terabit SSD for this Christmas. Some reason he thinks I'm a Santa Claus. I'm not a Santa Claus. Santa Claus don't wear no flannel shirt. You need a pair of glasses for Christmas, what you need. Christopher says, I got plenty of whiskey waiting for you, sir, Mr. 949er. Your teeth. I ain't gonna supple on your teeth. No matter how much you ask me, I leave the teeth pulling to the cows and the milk. I let the handmaidens do that, so I don't care if there's whiskey in your teeth. I ain't pulling that teeth. But if it's my treat, you can buy me a whiskey. Resknor says, no guts, no glory. Now, let's see what other news that I found. Think I had another one? You're not hearing me at all. One, two. I hope you heard anything that I said. One, two. Give me a yes if you can hear me. Okay. I was just telling you about cryptocurrency, and I just wasted a whole lot of time. Hate when that happens. Sorry about the sound. I don't know. Maybe out of my excitement, I hit the button. I was saying, all these cryptocurrencies you can store in the bank, and Germany wants to store them. But if you put the cryptocurrency in the bank, it's not yours. You gotta make sure you hold on to your cryptocurrency. If you put it in a bank, or put it in an exchange, they give you a little piece of paper, just like dollar bills. So, what they do is they get 100 of your cryptocurrencies, and then they make 200 pieces of paper. And they give it away. And that's all good, until everybody comes back and says, give me back my cryptocurrency. And there's 200 these little pieces of paper, and there's only 100 cryptocurrencies. So somebody ain't gonna get their crypto. All you got is a piece of paper. That's just like a dollar bill. They keep making more and more of these dollar bills. Now they're fancy, like they got a little plastic strip. They have lots of different funny colors on the front of them. Let's see. Lots of funny colors on them. And they got a little window where you can look up to the light and see Benjamin Franklin. But it's just a piece of paper. And that's called a fractional lending. They don't have any assets to back up the piece of paper. So make sure that you keep your crypto. You youngsters need to do that. Now, I may not see $1 million Bitcoin. I'll be buried in my hat and my boots. But you guys will. If it ain't your crypto on your ledger, it ain't your crypto. You just got a piece of paper. You've been made a fool. Because this ain't worth anything. It's just a post-it note. Get an ETN collector out there. That's Mr. Hank. The ETN collector. He likes collecting the Electroneum. I don't blame him, it's a good coin to be collecting. The German bank webpage. Alright. So, I pretty much put it in a nutshell. Told you what I was thinking. That they're gonna hold on to cryptocurrencies. But you smarter than that. You're going to make sure you hold on to your own cryptocurrency, keep it in your possession. This way you know you actually got it. We got an Escher 36. Dino ain't here today. He's definitely at home having some Thanksgiving Day turkey. But I'm just filling in for the job. So, kind of works out. He gave me his Electroneum phone and some instructions. You can see him all the written instructions here. So I'll just do the best I can. Tell you about everything. See what else we got. Close that down. Hey, did you guys see Richard Hart and Tone Vase? Those two guys have been boxing it out. Right punch, right punch, duck, duck, right punch. They were going at it. I kind of like Richard Hart. Not sure if I like the hex thing, because it's based off a Bitcoin clone. So everybody that has Bitcoin get the free Bitcoin. Should be earning it from the beginning. So it's not my favorite thing to do. Let's see. We got a Rick Vipermoto. He's saying I'm doing minor 49er. I'm doing just fine. Candy Girl says, hey, Santa Claus, aren't you busy making presents? Christmas is coming. For you, Candy Girl, I'll be Santa Claus. For Chris, I ain't Santa Claus. Carl Ultra says, hey, Minor 49er. Any ideas on the bank monster deal that Richard Ailes mentioned to anyone? I have some ideas. Yeah, I think he's talking about monster deal gonna be with the government. I think he's working with the government so that Electroneum can be set up as an officially approved currency in the country in question. So once that happens, that means Electroneum can officially be spent in that country and used, saved, lent, whatever necessary, at any location in the country. So the question is, what country it'll be? And that will definitely be a big monster deal. Now, if it's an itty-bitty island country, maybe not so big. But I have a feeling it's going to be a big country. With lots of people. And then once you get one country taking it, you know that the rest will take it too. First mover advantage. No doubt. Electroneum gonna be massive. Christopher right on target. Once this is approved, yeah. I know they've been trying to get it approved for last year. And then the lawyers back it up, want more stuff. They complain because it's yellow and it's supposed to be blue. The font's too small. But those fellas work it out, and it'll happen at some point. And once it does, the entire crypto industry is gonna be in a shock. They won't even see this coming. Now you, smart enough, cause you watch Minor 49er, and you know what's gonna happen with this here Electroneum. You know this is coming down the pike. So between now and then, spend your time accumulating Electroneum. That's obviously not financial advice. Do I look like a financial planner to you? I'm just a guy in a beard digging up coins. Christopher says that he's gonna FOMO in. Can't help but do that. All cryptocurrency right now is basically in the accumulation stages. You want to accumulate as much as you can. Whatever you can afford. So I answered all your questions. I showed you the news. And so I think that today's special is done. I appreciate you stopping by and watching me talk on this here microphone. It's a fancy one. Got little dials. And Dino will see you on the next show. Happy Thanksgiving to you, and enjoy your weekend. Bonner 49er, come see me again.